Hey, hey, what's up, farming friends? It's me, your old buddy, Mr. Moose, back with another Farm and Simulator 2017 Mod Showcase. And today, we're doing another map tour, just because I know a lot of you guys are probably looking for new places to play, and today, we are somewhere in Thuringia. That is the name of the map. It is based on a portion of Germany, inside the state of Thuringia, and it's a really nice map. It's huge, too. I will bring up the in-game HUD for you and let you see the size of the map. There's like 37 fields in it, a ton of areas that you can do forestry, and the map itself is just enormous. So yeah, there's a lot that you're going to be covering on this map. Sell point wise in the game, there's not too many, maybe four or five of them. You've got your biogas, you've got a barn for selling hay and grass, and then you've got four additional sell points for selling your grains and fruits, and then you've got your spinnery and your lumber mill. So those are your sell points. At least you do have some competition. The last map we reviewed only had two sell points on it. This one has four. So at least you do have some options on it. There is a train on the map, but it is not drivable. It only goes up and down. It's your standard FS15 type train. And in all honesty, I do believe this is a port over from FS15. Though it's not a map that I saw during FS15, it is probably a port over from FS15 that has been reworked for 17. But it's a really nice map. And yeah, I think it's something you could have a lot of fun with if you're into it. The terrain, the aesthetics of the map are just absolutely wonderful. You notice you don't have all square fields, which is something I'm always looking for, because while I do like huge fields, I don't like square blocks. I do like some character in it. I've said it before, I like some rolling hills, I like things like that. Now, I don't like the typical European hedgerows right up to the edge of the field type thing, but I do like some some fields with a little bit of character, and this map has all of that. You start off with only two fields purchased, 20 and 24, but as you notice, all the fields in here do have missions assigned to them. So that blows my whole theory about having to limit the number of missions that we had on the North Brabant map. So on this map, everything's got a mission on it, with the exception of the two fields that you already own. So if you're into doing missions, you got plenty of missions you can do. If you want to avoid missions altogether, you can do that as well. So we'll take a little bit of a look at some of the just characteristics of these fields and how they shape out. And lots of rolling fields here. This particular field 24 that you're going to own and start off with, if you look at it, man, it goes right up a hill. It's got a telephone pole in the center of it, looks like maybe a tree in the center of it, which I'm not a huge fan of trees in the fields. I can always cut it down and get rid of it, it's not in the field, it's up to the edge of the field. That's a good thing. So yeah, you got a lot. I mean, this is on a hillside, sloping over. Nice big field here to work into. So I'm sort of digging the layout of this already. So let's go check out the farmyard and grab ourselves a vehicle, and we'll do a little walkthrough around this this particular map, and we'll just see what it's all about. I'll take you guys on a tour of it. Maybe it's something you guys want to see. You've got a little bit of farm stuff, field storage or equipment storage here behind the main house. You've got a shed over here. This looks like, again, this is the reason why I think this is probably a port over. It's got the doors on here that are opened up, but it looks like maybe this had automatic map triggers on it, or automated door triggers or whatever it was from 15. You do have your chickens are here on the farm right next to the house. So this is where your chickens are. Clucking it up. All right, so then we come around here, and your sheep are right here. Another nice thing about this map, pretty much all of the livestock is at the main farm, with the exception of the pigs. No idea like that. So your sheep area is right here. And then, of course, this is the pasture area for them. The sheep continue down here to where your wool pallet collection is down here at the bottom of this building here. A lot of these buildings are for FS 15 again, so again, it does make me think that this is probably an FS15 map, so. Looks like there's a trough right here. Can I get up there to look at it? Yeah, there is. There's a trough here. And a trough here. I don't know if you actually have to come in here to feed, or if you do that from down below. I'm thinking you probably do it from down below. And that's what your marked out areas down here are. You magically pull in over here and do your feed and your feed and water probably right here. That's probably what this all is. All right, so a couple of carts that you own. And another storage barn here. A couple of more carts back here on this side. And then we'll just kind of go around here back in the back. Some of the storage sheds here. So you have lots of equipment storage that you can use. More equipment storage here. Definitely give you plenty of equipment storage. Let's see. More elevated fields up there. Sort of like a root storage area here. Another small equipment storage thing. It's like, boy, there is no shortfall on equipment storage. Combine over here. There's a Massey Ferguson. Your silos in the center. What do we have over here? This looks like some sort of grain storage area here. You get the silos over there, so I don't know what you would put in here, but you've got a little ramp to go up to load into the back of some tippers. You got some piping here, like this has got a grain drop on it. Though I don't see a grain drop anywhere. Let's see if there's one here on the side of it. No, no grain drop on the side. There's a button there that doesn't function. Again, little things that lead me to believe this was an FS15 mod. But there's the new gazebo. More storage over here. We got grain and fertilizer. Seed and fertilizer anyways. Wonder if they're usable. Let's jump into here real quick. And we will back up onto this. Connect that. If it's usable, we can... Oh, yeah. So, he's put the triggers in for seed and fertilizer. So, if you don't like the... if you're not fond of the new system, you can just use these here. Should be able to get seed out of this one, right? No? Wait, I can get fertilizer, but I can't get seed. That's interesting. Okay, I just gotta look at the hitbox here. I don't really see a hitbox for it. I can see a big, huge hitbox in there for fertilizer, but I don't see one for the seed. Maybe I'm missing something. Or maybe I switched off of it. That's what I did. There it is. Alright, so yeah, seed works off of it too. I accidentally slipped off of it when I put the weight on. Dumb me. Alright, so anyways. I'm going to use this tractor to drive around a little bit. And we'll take our little look around the rest of the farm. So equipment wise, let's look what we got in the garage real quick. So we'll go into the store, go into the garage. You've got the case 1455 XL to start off with, the Fendt 300 Vario. I think this is set as a 313. The New Holland T6, that might be what we run around the map in. It'll go a little bit faster than all of these. That one's 24, that one's 24, and I think this one's 31. Yeah, and then you got the Massey Ferguson Activa 7347S. You've got a Acapella head, which is a multi-head. And then you've got the Free Flow Massey Ferguson 25-foot head. So you can do pretty much everything. This is sunflowers, and then you can do pretty much a lot of your other fruits and vegetables with this. I don't see a corn header on here. You got two Metaltech trailers, two AgriLiner trailers, a 3-meter Kuhn cultivator, but then you've also got a 4.8 meter Horsch. You've got the nice large Amazon 3-meter plow, Amazon seeder for doing corn, sugar beets, sunflowers, soybeans, and then you've got the Great Plains 3-meter planter for the rest of your fruits and vegetables. You got a sprayer combo here, front tank and your rear sprayer, a few weights, and that's it. So pretty good selection of equipment though for starter group, as far as plows, heads, things of that nature for your combine. All right, so what else have we not met yet? There's the grain silo there for your drop for it, so you don't need that other area. Let's see. This over here is more equipment storage. Storage. La, la, la. Use your words, Moose. Let's chip out of here. This is your dairy area. And so your feeding is right up through here. And this will also be the same area that you have to clean up because of the little yellow lines there. Let me know that. But yeah, this is your dairy area for your cattle. A little watering over there. Feeding there. Not huge. There's some pasture that goes up this back hill. So your chickens, sheep, and dairy cattle are all on the same same farm. And then the pigs are down the road a little bit. The pigs are up over here by 1617. We'll get to those eventually. And we'll go check out that facility. Let me get my cam here. We'll pull forward just a little bit, grab a weight. I don't want that. I really don't need the weight on the front of this, but we'll go ahead and drive with it. Slurry right here for you. Manure right next to that as well. Get that out of the way, and then we'll go on for a little drive. And that's pretty much the main yard. There's water there for feeding. And again, I told you there's some pasture up here for the dairy cattle. Now, there's a couple of silage clamps down in the farm there. And then there's this area up here that looks like this would be a silage bunker as well. And maybe it was in 15. If you know, like I said, there's little things that just keep making me think. Port over. But if I look at this in the wireframe, there is no foundation here at all for silage. So I can't do, this is not a silage pit. If I drive through it with the help menu out, there's no compaction information. So again, it further lets me know that this isn't an actual area to do silage out of. But it's a good looking, you know, all the same. Where did I want to go out of here? I was looking for something specific I was going to do up here. I think I was going to go down this way to get out of here. That's what I was going to do. So there's a couple of little things also I noticed about this. While the fields are cut irregular, it seems like if the missions are on it, the missions grow in kind of uniform and square, so you'll be able to plant the field and utilize the entire field, but the mission system doesn't seem to recognize the field's irregularity and fill it all in with as you would think it would. So I was curious about that, why the fields weren't fully seeded, and then it dawned on me that that's probably what the whole deal was. So we're going to take a little drive around here. I'm going to take the scenic route around to get to a lot of stuff. Showcase off the majority of the map. I hope you guys enjoy the run. And we'll just go through here. So again, there is a lot of forestry on this. You get a lot of trees that you can cut down. And there's some added storage like on the beaten path or off the beaten path. As you come down here, there's a little bit of storage area here. So if you wanted to put wood chips or equipment or such, if you were doing forestry, you definitely have that over here. And then we got some pretty steep hills to climb here. To get on out of here. A lot of terrain on this map, so a lot of changes, a lot of rolling hills, nothing is flat. I do like that. It gives a lot of character to the map. It makes it look really, really nice. And I'll try to showcase off as much of that for you guys as I can. That's one of the reasons we're going the perimeter out here instead of just driving right up the heart of the map, taking some more roads. And again, we're going to see that there is plenty of forestry. So if you're into doing ag and forestry, this might be a map for you. The trees are a little more spread out than my liking. I like it when they're bunched up close together and not, you know, just huge gaps in between them. But that's just when you're doing a map this size, I'm sure some little shortcuts have to be made because you're not going to sit there all day and drop trees. Another little rail crossing here. And as I said, there is some rail on the map, but it is not your typical rail or the new FS-17 rail where you have drivable trains. Nothing is drivable. As you see, there is a train in front of us. And this will be the first drop-off point that we come to. As we make our way around the map here. Now, one thing's funny, this particular field right here, if we look at the map, we're down at field 22 and see how it wraps around and there's a road there. Again, the mission system doesn't recognize the boundaries of the field and actually plopped in all this growth right here on the paved road. And yeah. So I don't think the field completely extends down through there. I think that would go away after a bit. But it seemed like the mission system has nothing but square fields. Alright, so here's one of our sell points if we come into here. Back here in the back there is a train. And the drop-off point for the train is right here. And of course, as always, because I'm just, you know, a kid at heart, gotta send the train. And it rolls away. Does it have a bonus on it? I don't know. And for those of you who don't know what I'm talking about, typically with trains that you can send in the game, there is usually, in FS15, there was always a bonus. Whereas you would sell your goods for a certain price and load them onto the train. And then once you sent the train, you would get a bonus later down the road for the goods that were on the train. So I don't know if that is a thing in FS17, but you do have a couple of sendable trains on this particular map. So if it is a thing, you might be getting a sales bonus as well at these stations that do have the... that do have the trains on them. All right, so oops, swung out a little wide there. Let's go ahead and make our way up the map a little bit, enjoy a little bit more of the beauty of Thuringia. As we continue up, now we're on the eastern side, southeast side of the map, and we're going to come in here. This is where our logging area is, or our sawmill. As you can see, we're down here in the bottom of the right-hand side of the map. And when we come in here to the sawmill, it's very nicely done. There are some different sell points in here that you can hit. And I find it interesting. I don't really know. There's a question mark here about the mill pond. But there is no pond here, so I don't know why he put that into this. And I don't know if that functions as a mill pond or what, but I will show you in just a second. Now, a couple of the cranes from the new portion of the game have been added in. Though this train is not drivable and does not move, if we jump up here into the crane, you're going to see that he has, in fact, added in a little sell point here where you could bring a flatbed in here or a delivery wagon, a logging trailer of sort, and you could unload it with the crane and then set the logs onto there, and that is a sell point for you. So you do have a sell point there. Let's go run around a little bit more. We'll jump over the tracks here. Highly unsafe. There is another working crane here. However, if I jump up in it, this crane works as well. And function, it has complete functionality. Though I do not see a sell point that this thing could reach, unless going back here to where the mill pond trigger was, there is, in fact, see if I can get this over here. If I go into the wire screen of this, you will see a sort of rounded out area where that, and that trigger is right in the center of it. So see the yellow polygon here? That would be indicative of a sales trigger. And I'm wondering if that is the yellow tree, if that is the sales trigger that you would back into the pond at a sawmill that would give you the sell point on a mill pond. If that is in fact the case, then maybe you can bring logs off of a trailer, bring them over here, and drop them into this, maybe onto this stack over here, and that would trigger off as a sale. Not really sure about that. There is a sell point there as well. Right here on the ground. So you could just drive into it, and then it would load onto this particular train here. Let me get rid of that wireframe. This particular sell point loads onto this train here, which, of course, and again, I can't pass a train without sending it. Choo-choo! That train does roll on. So if you take the time to back around here through this tight, tight little corner, you might be able to get in here, but the I'm not really sure about this crane, though. I would love for it to work. Now, you notice those logs are, they're not collidable. I can walk right through them. This set of logs here, not collidable as well, which leads me to believe that if this is, in fact, a sales trigger where I could, if I could lift the logs over here and bring them over here and drop them, like, into this pile, since the pile is not collidable, the logs would fall right through them and disappear into the sales trigger. I don't know. I can't tell you 100% on that. But it does seem like maybe that's what's going on there. I mean, one would think that if you're going to add in the, if you're going to add the crane in and make it functional right there, that you would have some sort of trigger that would be able to be utilized with that operation. So anyways, take a look at that. That might be something that you can experiment with if you decide to play this particular map. And if you do, and if you've experienced, make sure you leave a comment in the show notes for some folks and let them know, because I'm sure they would like to know it. One thing about these videos, people tend to find them down the line, and they come back 6 months from now and we'll watch these videos, and they'll be like, oh, I wonder if that works. So if you comment on it, they'll be able to see it. Wood chip here, using the old biomass heating inlet from 15. So again, another little, you know, another little feature that just makes me think that, yeah, this was all taken out of 15. But it's nice. It's a nice blend of 15 and 17 to make a nice map that will be something that you can have fun with. So around here is our livestock purchase area. I don't see any markings on the ground for where you're supposed to be doing the livestock purchase. It was on the stock map, it's right here, and okay, it is right there. If we go into the wireframe, since there is no markings on the ground, if we look at the wireframe, you'll notice this yellow block right here, this is actually your trigger point. So that yellow block is going to be your trigger point for purchasing your livestock. So that's where you back your trailer up to if you are so inclined to use your animal transport to bring and sell your animals. All right, I had to do a little quick edit because I hit the wrong buttons and put a little music into the game that I don't need. So I'm trying to get rid of that wireframe. There we go. Now it's gone. Mistakes were made. Mistakes were made in the creation of this video. All right, so let's roll on up the road. Again, more areas where you can do forestry. You are not limited, definitely, on where you can cut trees down. Cool little water elements here with the little waterfall and the pond here. More trees on our right that we can cut. That whole area off to the left is an area where you can cut trees. All right. We'll come right up here. Past these little houses here. And just on the other side of this brown house, there is a barn with a sell point for straw and grass, hay, things of that nature. So yeah, you can back into here. That's off of Bjornholm, I believe. This was the straw sell point on it. So, all right, so that little feature is there. Let's look at our map, see where we're going next. Let's duck around the corner here and check out the shop. Got a little construction going on here. Somebody's either getting a new septic line or some fiber put in. Gas station right here for getting fuel. Here we go. Come on around here. I know I should have my beacons on, right? Okay. I haven't even thought about it until now, but I'll put my beacons on to make y'all happy. Let's go ahead. We've got a little shop here. This is where you get your equipment and sell it all off and all that good stuff. So yeah, your reclaim or sell point is right there. I'm driving like an old guy with a blinker on again, right? All right, we'll jump right across the street here. We have another grain storage area or grain sell point. We pull back in here. There we go. We come back here to the Thuringer grain and ag. And we'll sell off there. Drop back around to the front and we'll head on out. Now, pretty close at this point, we're pretty close to where the pigs are. And again, I'll bring up my map so we can see where we're at. We're now midway up the western side. And what we'll do is we'll make our way over to 17, field 17, and the piggies. And then we'll make our way up to the northern part of the map. And we'll go from there. As we take our scenic tour somewhere in Thuringia. Yeah, see these guys? They're, looks like they're cutting a little fiber in. Doing a little construction there. Alright, down here, the building in the orange, that's going to be our piggy farm. Oinky oinky. Okie dokie, oinky oinky. Make our way down here and we'll just check out this facility, see what she's all about. Cut off this blue blazer. There we go. Slurry point right here. This is, I believe, the delivery and the sell point right here, or the delivery pickup point. Then you've got your little water trough here to feed them with. and another feed trough right there to feed out of. Vehicle storage in case you want to keep some stuff over here. Back over here, more storage as well. So if you want some more equipment back over on this side to store. And then there's another trigger point here. I believe this was straw on this side. I could be completely wrong on all of those. Again, this is somebody has customized the pig area a little bit. So how they lay things down is, you know, up to them and only me to guess. Another one of your oddly shaped fields that the menu system or the mission system doesn't quite pick up the field sizes and fill it all in, but you would be able to, you know, completely fill that field all the way in if you wanted to, if you were so inclined. What do we got down here? Looks like we can take a shortcut down here to get down through this area. Just take a look down here at what's down in this area. It looks like just in construction stuff. Some eye candy. Something to do with the construction of a new rail viaduct, it looks like. Alright, so we're here. We can jump over to 9 and cut across the water, it does look like. Oh, these guardrails are not collidable, by the way. You pretty much can just drive right through them. Well, there's a lot of construction over here. Development is a good thing, right? Yeah, this map has got a ton of character to it, so totally digging that. Totally liking the fact that it's just not your same old map. Definitely leads me further to suspect, even though I haven't seen it before, that this is an FS15 map, because I don't think anybody put this much time and effort into a new 17 map, not at this point. Alright, so we cross over the water. A couple of fields here you can work with. What do we have here? We've got another little farm, it looks like. It looks like we have a second farm here. Yeah. So that's nice. This is like the little entrance in Court Farms. It is the entrance from Court Farms. Seed and fertilizer there for you. Ton more equipment storage here. So if you wanted to have a, you know, northeast farm, you could have one. Grain silo here. No livestock or anything here on this farm. Alright, so we'll wrap on around. Just great scenery though. Very, very nice map. If this was an FS15 map, I hate that I missed it, because it is, it's got a ton of character to it. More trees you could cut. Come to think of it, I do remember a map called Somewhere In, and I don't remember what the proper name for it is, but maybe it was Thuringia. Maybe I just never checked it out. I'm sure by now several people have already commented in the comments. Yeah, Moose, I played that map a million times. You're an idiot. Can't believe you never played it. All right, Slowpoke, come on, get out the way. Get out the way, buddy. You're holding up traffic. right, more construction up there as they work on the new highway, or I guess it's German, so Autobahn. A little sunflower field for you. Again, the mission system not fully growing that in. The collision with that, just the roundness of the field, I guess. The reason it didn't plop it all in there. Let's see where we're at. Alright, got a little bridge here we need to take. I see some biogas facilities. I spy a biogas facility. Let's go check her out. Alright, so we got, looks like, 5 clamps here for our biogas facility. Big slurry tank here. A little equipment storage. Drop back around. And your gas bubbles, and then down here, your input. So you can drop everything in. And a truck that is oddly placed. Somebody's gonna have a bad day when they get off work. That's a heck of a practical joke someone has played on this fella. Wow. Man, you've been working so many hours, we built steps and a biogas facility right into your vehicle. We told you to move it, but you didn't come pay attention, so sorry about that. That's a quite interesting feature there. Yeah, the car placement here leaves a little something to be desired. Alright, how do we get out of here? Oh wow, I don't think we do. I think we have to go all the way back. Are you kidding me? Wait, no, look. It looks like there's a shortcut out of here. There's a dirt road here. If we take this dirt road around the back, we should be able to get to where we need to go. Over the river and through the woods, we will eventually get to where we need to be. Uh-oh. Need a little four-wheel drive to get up that hill. There we go. Alright, out the back we go. And around this field here. And we should be home free. And there's a little collision on that fence. Yeah, garden facility from 15. Definitely a port over. And some of y'all are wondering why I keep saying that, or why I keep mentioning it's a port over. There's a lot of people who want to know that. A lot of people who, again, like me, might have not seen this map when it was in 15. But you want to know if it was a port over, or if it's something that somebody has developed from the ground up. Because there may or may not be underlying issues with the map that can pop up from the fact that it's ported over from 15. It might not be multiplayer compatible, and it may have little quirks here and there because it wasn't built from the ground up. So, because I have heard some map guys say that there are some issues with porting maps over that you just don't know about. So, that's why I mention it. It's not that I'm complaining that it's a port over, it's just that I'm just bringing it to your attention. So that you know that there might be some sort of little issues underlying. So let's see what we got here by bringing up the menu again. I do believe we're here at the spinnery, probably. Yep, selling point for wool. Plus, we have another sell point here for grain at this point. Got a little windmill there. Okay. So we'll bring her around. And we'll check out what's down here at field 11. And we're getting closer to being done here. As we've covered a pretty good segment of this map. As we head down the west side of the map now. Pull in here. Another sell point here. Let's see. This is the... Isn't this the new piece out of... I want to say this is new out of 17. But anyways, there's a drop-off point there. And looks like a load point here. To where you can get goods back into your trailer. Though I don't know that you would need that if you're selling off. Anyway, so another sell point. Yeah, I believe that's out of 17. I believe there was a train supposed to be right there on that side of it. Nice use of the materials. Pretty nice map. Let me give that a little toot of the horn. Forgot to turn my beacons back on. Let's do that. Don't want to get in trouble, though. I'm running faster than all the rest of the traffic is. Alright. At this point, just some windy roads that go to different areas of the map. This will take us back to the inside of the map. And we'll basically head back down towards the farm. At this point, you've pretty much seen everything on the map, with the exception of just a little bit more terrain and some of the fields that are on here. So we'll include a link to this map so that you can download it if you so desire and want to play it. I found this on... Which site did I find it on? I think I found this on LS Mods 2017. Either that or Mod 17. One of the two I found it on. Not 100% sure which one I found it on. We already went this direction, so let's go this direction. Make our way back down the map. There we go. Like I said, I like the map. It's got a really good balance of agriculture and forestry, rolling hills, really, really nice amount of aesthetics and good topography. Which is very important to me. But at the same time, it's got that European feel, but it doesn't have all the hedgerows right up against the farm, so you're not going to run into those the entire time. But like looking at that field going up that hill like that, that is awesome. And you could even plow more of it out, it looks like, if you so desire. Hey, see, I'm going to dig a shortcut. I know. Boosh, you're driving through the field. I know, but still, there's even more of this that we could come over here and cut out and make this field a little bit bigger if you wanted to. Because you could plow all this up. Or you could just leave this for grass fields and do grass on this. Though, you'd have to plow downhill. or have a big, huge tractor to be able to plow this. Okay, it would be a challenge, wouldn't it? But anyways, I hope you guys have enjoyed this look at our map somewhere in Thuringia. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. If you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. There's a gold nugget laying on the ground. And if you haven't already, subscribe to the channel. I do new videos each and every day. Wow, isn't that a good shot? I believe that's like a thumbnail shot right there. But anyways, yeah, there's a lot about this map that is really cool. And it might be something that you want to play. But anyways, if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do. I do new videos each and every day. And I try to live stream in the evenings when I'm awake and feeling good. But anyways, yeah, hope you liked it, guys. Check out the link in the show notes if you did, and come back and join us tomorrow for another video. Until then, stay safe, have a great day, God bless you, and I'll see you later. Bye-bye.